Good morning. Thank you very much, Christy. That's also a great grand event there. I love going there. Okay, but we're at the Stan Hewitt Hall and Gardens, and it's Christmas time, and they have awesome stuff. We talked about Dazzle, the light show. But when you come into the main mansion, there's a beautiful themed Christmas array, and I'm talking to the debonair decorator and designer himself. I say that because he has his cool jacket on. Okay, so good morning, Nathan. How are you?
Good morning, good.
From Pam's Posies?
Yes.
Pam's okay. Posies. All right, so Nathan, you took your inspiration just from the heart. They didn't give you a postcard, so you kind of went from the heart, right?
Yes, I have a cute nature for historical homes and things like that.
Okay.
So I thought I'd try to decorate similar to how the Cyberlings would have maybe done it, with a little bit of updated version. She probably wouldn't have had lights and things
right.
like that.
LED lights, yeah.
At least, you know, try to pay homage to them.
Well, this is the first one we're going to look at a piece of your art. Tell us about it.
Well, we have this traditional cranberry breeding, which would have been real if they would have used that.
Okay.
And then the red velvet bows with the greens and the nice sleds.
Yeah.
It just really lends itself nicely to the home.
Very good. Nice touch. And of course, you have
our Santa here as well. He's period specific.
Okay. So I thought you might have been a member of Cirque du Soleil because you also did this one, but you said you didn't have to find the ladders to swing all over the place to get this up, but this is a big piece of work. Let's talk about this, Nathan.
Well, fortunately, my wedding woman, Paula, she came a week early and helped me out with this. They actually decorated on the ground.
Okay.
And then they kind of rig it up with like a rigging system and pull it up so we don't have to actually do it.
Yeah, that is amazing. How many feet was this?
Oh, I want to say it's at least 40, wow. 50 feet. They didn't actually give me a measurement. They just said, come decorate it.
Yeah, you know? Come decorate it. Okay, yeah. Well, talk about some of the designing cues we see here. What'd you do?
Well, we did a lot of clustering here with the big fruit, almost like a Williamsburg-ish thing. And we have the holly, and again, the red velvet and the berries, just kind of carrying the whole theme through. It's a big space.
Yeah. So lots of little details.
Yes.
Okay. All right. And then we come down here. Now this isn't as huge, but significant as well. Kind of ties things in.
And again, this is just like the Williamsburg, and they definitely would have done this in this home at some point.
Okay.
I don't know if they have pictures of it decorated for Christmas, but they would have used this fruit, and it would have lasted a lot longer than you think.
Yeah. Really.
And this is artificial, but
of
if
course.
You used fresh, it would last for a long time.
Okay. And then the pineapple. Nice.
The
touch.
Pineapple. It's welcome.
Yeah,
every home should have a pineapple at the entrance.
Okay. And finally, we're going to look at your Christmas tree, and I'll talk to Jules real quick because we're wrapping up. Okay, when people come out, Jules, the times and dates?
For the next two weekends is Thursday through Sunday from 5 to 8, and then starting the week of the 14th, 7 days a week with the exception of Christmas Eve and Christmas Day.
Mm-hmm.
But please check our website or call for specifics, ticket pricing, and especially parking because that can be challenging on the weekends.
But it's
parking is free, and we'll accommodate everyone. We'll get
all
you
right.
here.
Thank you so much, Nathan. Thank you so much, Jules.
Okay, right.
There's Nathan's tree. He decorated 25 trees this year.
Wow.
He's treed out. He's going to Bora Bora. No trees there.
Just palm trees.
Yeah, just palm trees. Right, right.
Sounds good. Hang a few balls and the tinsels on those and
there
you're good
go.
To go.